Okay, students, welcome to the second day digital class of this chapter, Elements of Geometry. Today, we will do the some examples which are proved on the base of Euclid's postulates.
This is the image of Euclid. Now, we will recall all the definitions and postulates of Euclid which are discussed in the last class.
Now, the Euclid definitions are here. They are a point that which has no part, a line is breadthless length, a straight line is a line which lies evenly with the points on itself. Next one is, a surface is that with the length and breadth only. Next one is, the edges of surface are lines. A plane surface is a surface which lies evenly with the straight lines on itself. These are the definitions given by Euclid which are in first book of Elements. Here Euclid axioms are there. First one is, things which are equal to the same things are equal to one another. Second one is, equals are added to the equals, the wholes are also equal. Third one, if equals are subtracted from equals, the remainders also equal. The fourth one, things which coincide with one another are also equal to one another. Fifth one is, things which are the double of the same things are also equal to one another. Sixth one, things which are halves of the same things are equal to one another. These are the six Euclidean axioms. These are also called as postulates.
We have to know about the hypothesis or conjecture. What is the hypothesis? Or conjecture? What is the conjecture? Sometimes a certain statements that we think that can be true on the basis of our experience or guess. These types of statements are said to be conjectures. So for example, every even number greater than 4 can be written as sum of two primes. This is a conjecture, because we can guess this statement without proof. So these type of statements are called conjectures. So let us study how Euclid axioms or postulates can be used to prove some examples. First example is there, that is, if A, B, C are three points on a line and B lies between A and C, then prove that AC minus AB is equal to BC. So here diagram is given in first example. A, B, C are three points on a line. A, B, C, these are the three points on a line. B is between A and C, and which is middle point of AC. So you have to prove that AC minus AB is equal to BC. So according to this figure, AB plus BC is equal to AC, because we remember that the Euclid's postulate is there, that is, if two things are coincident, then they are equal. That means if here AC is coincident with AB plus BC, so that's why AC is equal to, we can say that AB plus BC. So here you have to prove that AC minus AB is equal to BC. AC minus AB, that is equal, can be written as AC. You have to write in place of AC, you have to substitute AB plus BC. AC is equal to AB plus BC. That's why AB plus BC minus AB. There we can write as, it can be written as this. So like this, we can prove that AC minus AB is equal to BC using Euclid's postulate. So this is the an example. Next, another example is there. Prove that an equilateral triangle can be constructed on any given line segment. So second example is, to prove that equilateral triangle can be constructed on any given line segment. If you given, you have given a line segment, then you have to construct equilateral triangle on the given line segment. How can we construct the equilateral triangle? We can see now. So first of all, if you given a line segment like this, a line segment P2, given this, you have to construct an equilateral triangle on this. To construct this equilateral triangle, first of all, you have to draw a circle with the center P and radius P2. So like this, you have to draw a circle. Next, another circle with the center Q with the radius PQ. With the center Q, radius PQ, you have to draw another circle. So here the intercept, the point, and the point, let us take as R. So here you can join PR and QR. So here a triangle is constructed. Now we have to prove this PQR is the equilateral triangle using Euclid's postulates. We know that PQ is the radius of a circle with the center P, and PR is also a radius of a circle with the center P. So from the first diagram, PQ is equal to PR, that is radius, radius 1, we can say that radius 1. So from the second diagram, the circle in the center Q, here also QP is the radius, QR is the radius. Radius second, that is equal to PQ, that is equal to QR. So we know that the Euclid's first axiom, things which are equal to the same things are equal to one another. The first axiom says that the things which are equal to the same are equal to one another. So here the things P and Q are equal to the same thing P2. That's why these two are equal. So from this 1 and 2, we can say that PR is equal to QR, that is equal to physics. So from this statement, PQ is equal, UR is equal, PQ. So these three sides are equal. That's why the triangle constructed here is the equilateral triangle. So this is the proof of the equilateral triangle, which are constructed on the given line segment using the axiom of Euclid. Okay, next, another example, third example is two distinct lines cannot have more than one point in common. So third example is, you have to prove this. Two distinct lines cannot have more than one common point. So you have to prove using Euclid's axioms. So let us take, so example 3 is two distinct lines cannot have more than one point in common. So you have to prove this using Euclid's lemma, Euclid's axiom. So let us assume that two lines intersect in two distinct points A and B. Let two lines L and another line, take like this M, they have intersect in two distinct points. You have to prove that this is not possible. So we know that according to the Euclid's axiom, we know that only one line can be drawn through the two distinct points. But here, two lines are there, which are intersected with two distinct points. This is contradiction to the Euclid's axiom. That's why it is not possible. So we can say that only one common line, one common point for the two distinct lines. So we can say points A and B. We have to prove that L and M has only one common point. So we know that, we remember that the Euclid's axiom says that there is only one line can be drawn through the given two points. So this is the contradiction to the Euclid's axiom. Because of this contradiction arises because our assumption. That's why you can't draw like this. That's why you can say that only one common point, only one common point is there for the two lines. Okay. Next, another example is there, that is two line segments are given A, B, X, Y, and C, D are, C, D are the midpoints of the given two line segments, and given that AC is equal to, given that AC is equal to XD. We have to show that AB is equal to XY. So given that C is the midpoint of AB, that's why AB is the midpoint of CD. C is the midpoint of AB. That's why AC equal to CD. You can say that 2AC is equal to AB. And also we can say that 2XD is equal to 2XD is equal to XY, because of D is the midpoint of XY, XD equal to YD. That's why XY is equal to 2XD. We know that the one of the axes of Euclid, doubles of the equal things are equal. So here given that AC is equal to XD, we can double this both sides. 2AC is equal to 2XD. According to the Euclid's axiom, 2AC double of the, if two things are equal, then we can, the doubles of the things also equal. Here 2AC is equal to XD. 2AC means AB, 2XD is equal to XY. Therefore AB is equal to XY. So like this we can prove the given statement using the Euclid's axiom. Students, now we can see the exercise 3.1. Here some problems are given, simple problems are given. Now we can answer the all these questions using Euclid's axioms or postulates. So in the okay students, now we can do the exercise 3.1, which is based on Euclid axioms or postulates. Okay, now we can answer the questions in exercise 3.1. First question is, how many dimensions a solid has? We know that the solid, this is a solid. So how many dimensions are there? 3 dimensions are there. Length, breadth, height. 3 dimensions are there. Next question, how many books are there in Euclid's Elements? The Elements is the combination of how many books? 13 books. 13 books. Elements is a combination of 13 books. Okay, next third question. Write the number of faces of cube and cuboid. This is the cube. How many faces are there? 4 side, 4 faces, and the top surface, and here bottom also surface. So total surface are, how many surfaces? 6. Okay, next question. What is the sum of interior angles of a triangle? What is the sum of interior angles of a triangle? This is the similar postulate of fifth axiom of Euclid's axiom. So according to this axiom, sum of interior angles of a triangle is 2 right angles. Angle 1, 2, 3, you know that. Angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 is 2 right angles. That means 180 degrees. Next. Write 3 undefined terms of geometry. We already discussed about the undefined terms. What are they? They are point, line, plane or surface. These three are the undefined terms of geometry. Next, second sum. Here some statements are given, so I have to say that they are true or false. First statement: only one line can pass through a given point. Only one line can pass through the given point. Is it true? So we can see. Pick a point. How many lines can draw through this point? Number of points can be drawn like this. So this is, the given statement is false, because we can draw number of infinite number of lines through the given point. All right angles are equal. So already discussed about this statement. All right angles are equal. Next, third statement is circles with same radii are equal. Okay, this is also, if you take with the radius 3 centimeters, draw a circle. Another, take another circle with the same radius 3 centimeters, and take another circle with the radius 3 centimeters. If you take this through from these three circles, they are coincide with each other, then according to the Euclid's axiom, if two objects are coincide, they are equal. That's why these are coincide. That's why these are equal. So you can say, like, according to the Euclid's axioms, the circles with the same radii are equal. That's why this statement is true. Next statement: a line segment can be extended on the on its both sides endlessly to get a straight line. Already we discussed about this statement. A line segment, take a line segment AB, we can extend endlessly both sides. Next, another statement is there. That is, if a line is given, a line segment is given, so A, B line segment, C is the middle point. So given that AB is greater than AC, so we can say, according to this figure, a part is always less than whole. Here whole is AB, this is always greater than a part of AB, that is AC. That's why whole is always greater than a part. That's why you can say that AB is greater than AC. This is a true statement. Next, and third question is there. That is, a line is given. On the line, points are A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. These are the points which are on the line. So you have to show that AH is greater than AB plus BC plus CD. According to this figure, AB plus BC plus CD plus DE plus EF plus FG plus GH is equal to AH. If two objects are coincide with each other, then they are equal. According to this, AH equal to AB plus BC plus CD plus EF plus FG plus GH. This is always greater than AB plus BC plus CD. So because AB plus BC plus CD is the part of this whole, that's why this is always greater than this. That implies AH is greater than AB plus BC plus CD. Okay, next fourth sum is, if a point Q lies between two points P and R such that PQ is equal to QR. Prove that PQ is equal to half PR. Fourth sum is a line segment PR is there, Q is the midpoint between P and R such that PQ is equal to QR. That means Q is the midpoint of PR. So we have to prove that PQ is equal to half PR. But to prove that PQ is equal to half PR, so we know that according to the Euclid's axiom, PR is equal to PQ plus QR. So, but given that PQ is equal to QR, here PQ is equal to QR, so you can substitute the value. In place of PR, you can substitute PQ. So PQ plus PQ, because PQ is equal to QR. So here 2PQ, PR is equal to. If you divide divided by 2, both sides will get PR by 2 is equal to PQ. That is 1 by 2 PR is equal to PQ. Because according to the Euclid's axiom, if two things are equal, the halves of the two things equal, halves of the equal things are equal. That's why here these are equal. If you take half of these two, they are also equal. That's why 1 by 2 PR is equal to PQ. Next, I'll draw an equilateral triangle in whose side are 5.2 centimeters each. So you can try this diagram. I can explain this. So you have to draw a equilateral triangle whose side is 5.2 centimeters. So you have to draw this. I can explain this, how you can draw the given diagram. So take a 5.2 centimeters a line segment AB, 5.2 centimeters, and you have to draw a circle with this radius 5.2 centimeters with the center A, and here also draw another circle with the radius 5.2 centimeters with center B. So you can draw like this. So they intersected the point C, join AC and BC. Here the triangle is there, ABC triangle is there. Here ABC is the triangle. Now we have to prove this triangle is equilateral triangle. How can we prove? Here AB is the radius of the circle with the center A, and AC also radius of the circle with the center A. So that is AC is equal to AB. From this circle AB is the radius, and also BC is the radius. BC is equal to AB. According to the Euclid's postulate, if two things are equal to equal things, then they are equal to one another. So here two things AC and BC are equal to the thing AB. That's why here these two things AC is equal to BC. So AB is equal to AC is equal to BC. That's why ABC is the equilateral triangle. AB is equal to BC is equal to AC. So like that we can draw, construct a triangle, and we have to prove that this is the equilateral triangle. Next question. What is the conjunction? Already we discussed about the conjunction. That is also called as postulate. So what is conjecture? Is a statement which is neither proved nor disproved. That is the conjecture. Next, seventh question is, mark two points P and Q, draw a line through P and Q. Now how many lines are parallel to PQ? Through the line points PQ. Now our question is, how many lines can be drawn parallel to this PQ? How many lines can be drawn if you draw a line parallel to this, and we can draw a line parallel to this, and also we can draw a line here parallel to like this. How many lines can be drawn? Infinite number of lines can be drawn. Like parallel lines can be drawn to a given line. Next question. Here the diagram is given. The diagram is like this: a line L, another line M is there. This is L, this is M, and a line intersects the given lines M. So our question is, these two are the angles one and two. Our question is, what can you say about the lines L and M? L and M. What can you say about these two lines? According to the Euclid's fifth postulate, the postulate says that if you two lines, a line intersects two lines, and if you extend these two lines both sides, they can meet which side? The sum of interior angles are less than two right angles. That means 180 degrees. If sum of two interior angles is less than 180 degrees, then that side the two lines can meet. The two lines can intersect. So that is the explanation of this diagram. Next, ninth question is, a diagram is given. Like this. And the angles are 1, 2, 3, 4. This diagram is given. in this figure, given that angle 1 is equal to angle 3 and angle 2 is equal to angle 4 and angle 3 is equal to angle 4. What is the relation between 1 and 2? What is the relation between 1 and 2? So here angle 1 is equal to 2, angle 3 is equal to 4. Angle 3 and angle 4 are given that equal. These are equal to the things 1 and 2. That's why 1 and 2 are equal according to the Euclid's axiom. Next question. This is the last question. One diagram is given, a triangle is given. ABC triangle is given. This is a triangle. And X and Y are midpoints of AC and BC. That is, BX is equal to 1 by 2 AB and BY is equal to 1 by 2 BC and AB is equal to BC. So we have to show that BX. So we have to show that BX is equal to BY. So given that BX is equal to half of AB and BY is equal to half of BC and AB is equal to BC. These three statements are given. Using these three statements, you have to prove that BX is equal to BY. Using Euclid axioms. Here, given that AB is equal to BC, so according to the Euclid's axiom, half of the equal things are equal. So here AB is equal to BC. If you take half of this two things, AB by 2 is equal to BC by 2. So that is equal to 1 by 2 AB is equal to 1 by 2 BC. But 1 by 2 AB is equal to BX, 1 by 2 BC is equal to BY. So that's why BX is equal to BY. So like that you can prove as BX is equal to BY using Euclid's axiom. Okay students, this is the exercise 3.1. which is completed. Now another small okay students, another simple topic is there, that is non-Euclidean geometry. This is non-Euclidean geometry. So okay students, we know that Euclidean geometry is related to cube, surface, line and point. So after the Euclidean, Some mathematicians like Frederick Gauss, they go through the fifth postulate of Euclidean. That is, fifth postulate says that if you take two lines like this, if the sum of these two interior angles are less than 180 degrees, then they intercept this side. They take a surface like this and they take a lines, two lines A, B. Here the angles are 90 degrees, but they intercept here, see, and the angle here also more than 90 degrees. Sum of these three angles is greater than 180 degrees. So this is related to curved space. So the geometry related to the curved space or spherical space is non-Euclidean geometry. Okay students, this is the chapter regarding to the Euclid's geometry and non-Euclid's geometry. Okay. Thank you, Ananda.